Star Citizen's performance has always been a bit of a mystery to people, but no longer. CRG has added a frame time graph that you can open up in the console, and so now it's fairly straightforward to see if you are GPU or more likely CPU bottlenecked. It also shows the performance of the main thread and the render thread of the engine, and so there's lots of interesting information here. I'm going to explain how to open it up, what everything means, and show you how different parts of the game perform differently. It's pretty simple to get this open. It's the same as display info. If you've ever used that, hit the tilde key, hit R, underscore, and then tab. Display frame graph will come up. Just add a one there so it comes up. Hit enter, and voila, it is up. Now, when you're not in game, you'll just get some numbers like this. And you'll notice at the moment that the frame number there is 16.7, which is effectively 60 FPS. And that is because in the menus, you are limited to 60 FPS. So even though these numbers are lower than that, which we'll come back to in a minute, there's no bottleneck from the numbers here. You're just being locked to 60 FPS. Right, we're in the character customizer and the graph now is giving us some stats. We're still locked to 60 FPS, but let me describe to you what is happening here. If you select display frame graph with a question mark, you get this description. So this graph shows a performance graph with basic timings. The lower gray line is the 16 millisecond line. I'll put an arrow here. And the upper is the 33 millisecond VSync target. So we've got effectively 60 FPS and 30 FPS. The yellow is the overall frame time. So that just shows you what's going on, the overall, and that will become very obvious as we get into some actual game footage. The green is the time for the GPU to do all its work, and the blue is just for the render thread. So the blue line at the bottom here is showing how long all the render stuff is taking. And you may be aware that this is obviously one of the big things that CRG has been working on with Vulkan and the Gen 12 render, trying to reduce the render thread, getting it basically out of the way. And this video potentially might show why Vulkan isn't going to necessarily improve many people's performance. And we'll come again onto that in a minute. Now, as we run around Lawville, let me just explain. I'm using my main system here, 7800X3D with the 4080, 32 gigs of RAM, all the details in the description. But this is about as high end on the CPU side, at least, that you can go at this point. And so what you'll notice here is that the frame time and the main thread are pretty much locked in step. You can see here that they're kind of hovering around the 30 mark, and that's showing a dip below 30 FPS. Now, this is the PTU. This is the .3 PTU stuff. They'll be logging stuff on here. I would expect this to perform slightly better when it goes live. I wouldn't take too much notice of the actual numbers. It's just to give you an idea of how to read the graph. But you can see that the main thread is the problem here. The render thread is quite low. No real issues whatsoever in terms of the render stuff, but the main thread, the thread that in the engine that does all the game logic, physics, all that sort of stuff, is basically the bottleneck. And so for a lot of people, they look at their CPU utilization, they say, well, it's not 100%, how can I be CPU bottleneck? But you got to remember that there's parts of the engine that have got to do their work, and they're relying on your CPU to get through it as fast as possible. And so for most people, the CPU will be the issue. So even here with the fastest CPU really available right now in Lawville with a 4080, with actually got DLSS on, so we're at 4K, but we're upscaling from 4040p. The CPU is the issue completely. Quantum travel has always been probably the hardest part for a GPU in the game. And you can see here that all the numbers are pretty close as we spool up and get ready to fly. But keep an eye on that GPU graph there. It basically now has overtaken the main thread, big spike there. But you can see that the yellow line and the green line are effectively on top of each other. So we are now being GPU bottlenecked. And so in your system, this is what you've got to look out for. Which number there at the top of this graph is closest to the frame time graph? And that effectively will tell you what is your bottleneck. To show this in a bit more, well, I suppose, exaggerated fashion, if I turn off DLSS, you can see that the GPU usage again, as we get into quantum travel, is gonna go up. Keep an eye on that graph. As we actually enter, you'll see that it rises up. And again, the green line now, it's a bit more exaggerated, so the numbers are a bit far away. GPU around the 90 milliseconds. And again, the frame, the overall frame, is therefore bottlenecked by the GPU. To show you some even more exaggerated GPU bottleneck examples, we're here on the Orizon roof. It's nighttime, but the clouds are still there. At the moment, they're on medium, but you're going to see as we scale up the clouds, you'll see that the bottleneck at the moment is actually on the main thread. But as we turn the clouds here, turn off DLSS, first of all, you can see that now the main thread still is just, the number is still slightly higher than the GPU, but it's pretty close. But now as we turn the clouds from medium up to high, very high even, the GPU now has risen up and is now the bottleneck. And then the main thread actually has gone up quite a lot as well. So it's quite hard actually to tell. Interestingly, the clouds seem to have an effect on the main thread as well. So that's quite interesting. But here, as we then turn the clouds onto slow or the photo mode, which is incredibly hard for the GPU. Look at that graph rise right up. And the GPU frame time now is way, way higher, 43. And so the frame overall is now taking 43 milliseconds to arrive. And so that is a kind of hyper exaggerated version of the GPU being the bottleneck. Again, I don't really recommend anybody plays with the clouds on the photo mode. This is the 4080. The 4090 will probably do a bit better. And actually, some of the AMD cards in my previous testing, the 7900 XDX, does handle the clouds slightly better, it seems, as than the NVIDIA cards. But not really for anybody to use for actual gameplay. It literally is for photos. Let's go down to a distribution center for one of these new save standard missions. You see, frame rate's great at this point. No real issues. But as we start to approach and start to, I guess, load in all the stuff, the graph goes crazy. It spikes everywhere. And the frame rate is plummeting. It does continue to reduce as we get closer. There's enemies here, all sorts of stuff, and we're around getting closer to the 30 FPS mark. And you'll notice that it's all on the main thread. You can see that the big problem that this game has got now is that all of the work that the main thread of the engine is having to churn through. And so, again, Vulkan has been kind of touted by some people in the community as this kind of silver bullet for performance. It's going to fix everything. But remember, that is all about the render thread. That's making sure the rendering part is working smoothly. And so you'll notice that in all of the testing I've shown so far and everything I've tested, there is no part where the render thread itself is the bottleneck. It's all on the main thread. And so, yes, I think at this stage, the rendering stuff will be great and it won't ever be an issue because in the past it has been the problem. And so the work that they've done on the Gen 12 renderer and getting all Vulkan stuff in will be a good thing overall, but from here I don't necessarily expect to see performance improvements with multi-threaded version of Vulkan. What CIG are going to have to do is optimize the main thread. So this tool effectively will just tell you if you are CPU or GPU bottlenecks. There's no more need to guess. I get a lot of people contacting me saying, oh, why, what's happening with my system, I don't know. Well, ultimately turn this on and you can see whether you are going to be bottlenecked by the main thread, which effectively means your CPU is in the way, or in rare cases, if you, I guess, had a really fast CPU but had maybe a really kind of low-end GPU, you might be able to see if you are GPU limited. But again, with upscaling, there's not really much reason to be GPU limited at this stage. It's a great tool. We've got to praise CIG for giving us something that actually helps us know, because again, people have been guessing about this for a long time. Great stuff, CIG.